Hello again, everyone. Here we are back at it, working on the right wing. Gonna go ahead and get this wing about halfway wrapped up in this video, or maybe about a quarter of the way wrapped up. But while I got you here, instead of walking through this video, I think what I wanted to do, just meeting with a couple of builders, and then reviewing all the comments on previous videos. I noticed a reoccurring theme in the questions I was getting, so I thought I'd do a bit of a Q&A. Or I guess more of just an A, because the questions are already there. But maybe just answer some of your questions, the most common questions I've been getting. And the first one being is, all about primer, right? I get the primer question just about on every other video, and everyone I talk to or meet pretty much asks me about priming. Do you need to prime? Do I have to prime? I think a lot of that boils down to a personal decision. You have to take in, several factors, environmental factors, where you live, where you are in relation to the coast, what type of, environment you're going to be in, whether your plane's going to be, where is it going to be stored? Is it going to be hangared? So a lot of questions there. As you can see, I've primed the internal components of the wings. I primed some of the internal components of the empennage. And, I did not prime any of the internal components of the fuselage other than the scene structures. And that's just for paint later on. I think it comes down to a matter of just understanding, factors of the conditions your plane is going to be in once it's going to be finished. Are you going to have it hangared? Are you going to have it stored outside? Do you live near the coast? Resale value may come into it. I don't know. I've never had to sell one of these completed, but I know the buying market is pretty hot right now. But there have been, tens of thousands of planes that have been built that are not primed. And, have had little or no corrosion issues over the years, whereas others have had major corrosion issues over the years. So I would say it's a personal thing, without getting into a primer war. You have to look at your situation, the circumstances, and make that decision on your own. As far as what primer I've been using the basic Rust-Oleum, rattle can self-etching primer. You can pick it up at your local hardware store, automotive store, whatever. And it's worked great for me on the RV-12. I did use the AKZO on the RV-10 project, and I love that stuff. I think it's great. Buying the rattle cans does get expensive. So if you're going to be priming pretty much all of your components of your plane, I do just recommend just going out and buying the AKZO or your preference of whatever primer you're going to use, in gallon size quantity. It's going to be a lot cheaper in the long run. I've gone through about a dozen rattle can primers just on the wings alone, from priming, probably more than that. And they're running $5-6 a can. So, 100, 150, 200 bucks on, a couple of gallons of primer, good aviation primer, is probably going to be better if you plan on priming everything. But, so that's kind of my take on priming. Not going to really dive more into it. Just understand your conditions and your preference. It does add some time to the build process, So, take that into consideration and resale value as well. So if you think it may impact that, or potential buyers, it may eliminate potential buyers. So let's see. Some of the other questions I've been getting is, how long is it going to take to build the RV-12? Realistically, this plane, with a set work schedule on it, it could realistically be finished in a year, year and a half. There have been builders that have built this plane in a year. And the thing it comes down to is really just having the availability of all the kits available to you when you're ready for it. So if you're thinking you're going to order the empennage kit and then wait till you're finished with that and then order the wings or the fuselage, it's going to take you more than a year to build, because you're going to be waiting for 6 to 8 months, 4 to 8 months, I'll say, just due to lead times just to get kits in. And then not to mention any issues you may have with inventory if something's missing. It all extends the process, so having all the kits available to you is key. Also, the amount of time you're going to have to work on your project, those are the two biggest things. But yes, it can be built in, I would say, a year, year and a half, as long as you have everything available to you to progress along. If you mess up on a part, you can have the next kit or another section of the plans you can work on while waiting on, you know, the part to come in that you need. So, all right, so this about wraps this one up. I know that's kind of a long-winded spiel, but in the next video, we'll go ahead and get the outboard edge of the wing revved up, and see y'all soon.